Howdy. Hello, we are Giraffe, an environmental consultant team. The government has proposed 4 sites A, B, C, D as new sites for special scientific interest for native woody plant species. We are asked to investigate and rank the biodiversity and biomass of woody plant species among the 4 sites. We'll spend 4 days field study in the wet season and another 4 days in the dry season. Our hypothesis is that the biodiversity and the biomass of A, B, C, D are not the same. And our new hypothesis is that the biodiversity and the biomass of A, B, C, D are equal. In this video, we are going to discuss the method and statistical tool we use in the study.
First of all, we'll do a preliminary test in order to find the minimum quadrats and the optimum sample size. In each site, we will do 8 quadrats, which is 20 meter multiple by 10 meter. And first, we will make 2 SS for map of the site. Then, we will select a random number for the horizontal axis and another random number for the vertical axis. And the quadrat will be the in the right downside of the intercept of 2 lines.
After selecting all quadrats, we started the investigation. Inside the quadrats, we will identify all the plants which are higher than 1.3 meters. Then, we will also measure the circumference of the stem at 1.3 meters for each individual.
Back to the lab, we will do some data analysis. First, we will plot the graph of number of species encountered against the number of quadrats, such as these. And from the graph, we know that if we make 4 quadrats in the site, we properly investigate all species in that site. Then, we should make 4 quadrats as 1 replicate, and all sites should be the same. In every 4 quadrats, we combine the data and calculate the biodiversity of Shearlong index. For the biomass, as we know the circumference of each individual, then we can calculate the diameter and calculate the biomass by of the individual plants by the regression equation. And each species will have its own equation in each season. Then we can calculate the total biomass in the 4 quadrats. Now, we know how many quadrats in each replicate, but how many replicates are required in each site? We can calculate it by G power using data we collected in all sites, and all sites should have the same number of replicates.
Assume we have to do 6 replicates. Each replicate consists of 4 quadrats, 20 meters times 10 meters. Then now we start doing the investigation. First of all, select quadrats by random number table. Do the same thing as before. Then we calculate the Shearlong index and biomass in each replicate. After that, we calculate the mean and the standard deviation of Shearlong index and biomass in each site. After that, repeat the same things in other 6 seasons. Now we come to the data analysis part. So, first of all, in order to find the possible test to determine the biodiversity and the biomass of different sites, we will first to do the descriptive statistics. After this, we will have a normality check by KSA and the normality report. If it is normally distributed, we will have a homogeneity check by the Hartless test, and we will set the significance at 0.05. If it is also passed, we will do the one-way ANOVA plus the Turkey test, and we set the significance at 0.05. If the data are not normally distributed and have unequal variance, we will first to do the data transformation and repeat the procedure again. If after this, if it is also not normally distributed or have unequal variance, then we will do the KW one way and over, and then the done test in order to file the biodiversity ranking and the biomass ranking between the four sites. And that's
bye bye.